Once upon a time, there was a people who possessed a considerable knowledge, a civilization whose messages have been handed over to us through time, a people whose prophecies have impressively started to come true, the Mayas. The eternal charm of mystery encloses the deep knowledge of this ancient civilization whose memory has been lost in the mists of time. The Mayan calendar is known and studied by dozens of researchers. In fact, many believe that it holds a prophetic message. However, its decoding is not yet complete. The Mayas were convinced that time is cyclic. Every 5,125 years, an era would end, simultaneously opening a new one. In South England, for a few decades, an incredible phenomenon has been taking place, fascinating and unsettling at the same time: the crop circles. Moreover, during the last few years, the mystery has become even more intriguing. On the crop fields, incredible Mayan figures started to appear. Is it possible that an incredible connection is concealed between the Mayan prophecies and the crop circles? Who or what could draw these pictograms with elements that join together past, present, and future? The message transmitted by these fascinating figures could have a great value for humanity. What if it were a new attempt at communication? Such a theory is definitely revolutionary, but there are strong obstacles deriving from the skepticism that circulates around the crop circles phenomenon. Most people are convinced that the pictograms are man-made, a trick organized by groups of jokers. This is the case. Never mind if enormous figures and extremely complex drawings appear overnight. So far, the large amount of data and information gathered and documented brought no results. However, in 2007, something incredible and totally unexpected happened. An event that shook the scientific approach to the phenomenon, strongly rebounding the theory that it is not a human work, but rather a form of communication made by a non-terrestrial intelligence. Is it possible that an alien civilization is trying to talk to us? During the night of the 6th and 7th of July 2007, a researcher named Winston Keach placed a series of cameras on the hill above the East Field near Silbury Hill, an area in the south of England which has always been popular for the crop circle phenomenon. Other researchers joined Mr. Keach. Gary King, a lawyer, very keen on this phenomenon, and his girlfriend Paula.
And at about 1:30 a.m. we went along to Knapp Hill. Arriving there, we met up with the cameraman that I'd met earlier in the day in the cafe, and he had a set of cameras with him on top of the hill, and he explained to me that he had some more cameras set up in his vehicle which he'd pulled through and parked on the hill overlooking Eastfield as well. When I got there, he told me that the two cameras that were in the car were infrared and visible light capabilities and very sensitive. Also, the cameras he had were on the hill with him was a still camera which had a long exposure, an image enhancing device, and also another very light sensitive camera. He showed us a scan of the field with the image enhancer, and we could see clearly at that time, about 1:35, that there were no formations in the field of Eastfield or the surrounding fields next to him. We sat there then until about 3 o'clock, just chatting and talking. And then just after three, there was a big white flash of light that completely encompassed the landscape. That reminded Wynne that he needed to go down to his vehicle and change the tapes over. So he went down to the vehicle, changed the tapes and came back. And we sat there then just talking for about 20 minutes further. And then just as some light crept in, just as some clouds must have moved away, there was a very imperceptible shadow that we could see on Eastfield. So I asked Wynne to look through his camera on the hill. He opened the viewfinder and looked through it and then said to us, you better get up and look at this. And it was at that point, which was about 3:45 in the morning, that we discovered there was a very significant formation in Eastfield. He carried on filming, and we waited for the light to come up some more, took pictures and danced around. We were very elated, and we waited until the light came up a little more, and then Paula and I drove down to the end of the field while Wynne continued filming, and he filmed us as being the first persons that walked into the formation at about 4:30. on later analysis of the footage that was taken in the car, there were two cameras running constantly all night from about 11 o'clock until 5 o'clock. So it completely covers the field. If any light would have been in that field, it would have been detected. And we've got cars and vehicles driving past at various times that are all logged, and the times of them are logged. So we know that the tapes are running for that period of time. There's about 16 hours of footage in total.
Some circles in the formation follow the uneven terrain and are deformed in order to appear perfectly round from above. A further evidence that indicates the inexplicable nature of crop circles.
Nobody could have been doing this formation. If there would have been 1/200th of a candlelight of light in that field, these cameras would have picked it up, and plus I feel that we would have seen it from the hill as well, because we were constantly maintaining an observation down on this field. Quite apart from the logistical aspect of making the formation like this, the complexity, the size of the formation, the fact that the circles are ovals so that they look circular from the air.
However, there is more to be surprised about. When they watched the recorded tapes, Gary King and the others realized that the cameras had caught the beam of light that reminded Wynne to change the tape.
When we analysed those tapes, we found that the first visible signs of the formation through the lenses of those cameras was actually at 3:20 a.m. and that the light flash that was picked up on the end of the first tape registered for 3.5 milliseconds as an EM pulse, which is very similar to a bolt of lightning. And it was 7 minutes after that, at 3:20, that first signs of the formation were picked up by the cameras in the car. But we again didn't see them until about 20 minutes after that. As far as I know, this is the only time that anything like this, where continuous footage, continuous tapes have been running all night and captured the field and eliminated any evidence of anybody being in there with any laser alignment measurement devices or lights of any kind. As far as I know, this is the best footage and most comprehensive footage available of when a crop circle takes.
A crop circle appeared in the space of one night. An incredible event caught by Winston Keach's cameras and witnessed by Gary King and Paula. Finally, this is the definite proof that crop circles have an alien origin. What happened in East Field on July the 7th, 2007, is bound to be remembered as one of the most significant events since the beginning of the phenomenon in the 70s. Moreover, another consideration is added to this. If the real origin of the crop circles were human, we would be facing a repeated act of vandalism against the owners of the fields in which the pictograms occur. But so far, no one has ever taken any legal action against unknown persons for the damages suffered. So the question arises, is it possible that the British farmers themselves may have the perception of the unusual and complex nature of the crop circles? Michael Glickman is one of the main historical investigators of the phenomenon. He tried several times to convince the owners of the fields on which the pictograms appeared to denounce the damage suffered to the authorities.
They're frightened. I've been to the farmers and I've said, here is a photograph of what you have got in your field. And they go, I don't want to see. Don't show me this. They're scared.
In addition to the claims by Michael Glickman, the direct testimony of the owner of a field where in 2007 a pictogram appeared is particularly interesting.
I never saw anybody make it, and it appeared, I think, in the middle of the night. It's a real work of art, very precisely created and very accurately. And it was in a crop of wheat, which was flattened onto the ground, and it makes it very difficult to harvest it when it's like that. So I estimate that it was probably about an acre of wheat which was spoilt. When I first looked at it, it looked extremely disappointing. It just looked like a bit of vandalism, destruction. My first reaction was to prevent anybody from coming to see it, because I thought they would do a lot more damage by walking into the field and traipsing about in my crop. But a few people arrived and they were very persuasive, and so I allowed them to come in and have a look around. And they were all very nice people. I think the most interesting thing about the crop circle was the people who came to see it, actually. We had some extraordinary people, and they were all convinced that there was some outside power from outer space coming to create this thing. And it wasn't until we saw the photographs taken from the air that we realized what a beautiful thing it was. No, never forget. And luckily we've got lots of pictures. A bit disappointing to look at on the ground, because you couldn't really see the formation. But the photographs taken from airplanes are absolutely amazing. And it was such a huge area. And it's very difficult to imagine how human beings could make that, because there would be so much measuring involved. And none of us can understand.
Not all farmers, though, were that keen. In August 2007, a formation had not been visited by anyone because of the violent opposition of the owner of the land. The farmer fiercely threw out anyone who approached his land with the intention to visit the pictogram, and harvested it a few hours after its appearance.
We've just been thrown out from the property in which the formation appeared, near the city of Marlborough. We came to this airfield to hire an ultralight aircraft and film the figure from the air, which will unfortunately disappear in a few hours. A figure over 100 meters across, a figure it has not been possible to investigate, but on the basis of what we have seen, it seems extraordinary. I hope that when we do fly over the area, the figure will still be there. Let's hope we're a little lucky.
Luckily, it was possible to photograph the circle before it was removed by the threshers. In fact, the wheat had not been harvested yet, and so the pictures show the figure imprinted in the field in all its beauty and harmony. It stands out, as the circle is very close to the farm. Actually, it would have been virtually impossible to make that gigantic symbol at night, and especially without letting the owner of the field notice anything. For a few decades, the crop circles have been causing excitement, fascination, divisions, and curiosity. The simplest questions have not yet found an answer. Who produces these designs, and why? The answers of science and of hoaxes. Groups of counterfeiters who make pictograms are not sufficient. Too often, the most spectacular formations have appeared over one single night, maybe even in bad weather, such as the famous one of Milk Hill in 2001. The greatest pictogram ever appeared until then, consisting of 409 circles, occupying an area of 90,000 square meters. Such events give even more credit to the theory of the non-human origin of the crop circles. A phenomenon that could really be the manifestation of a project concerning the entire human race? Charles Mallett, researcher for many years and owner of the Silent Circle Cafe, the most important meeting and information point for the scholars of this phenomenon, has no doubt about it.
For me, I'm personally 100% sure that elements of this phenomenon represent a direct interaction from somewhere else up here, and it seems to be connected with the Earth, with ourselves, our own metaphysical or spiritual development, the evolution of our species, and intrinsic in many of the patterns, especially the stuff which affects the South and Central American regions, the Mayan patterns, as we spoke about before. Highly interesting stuff, and this points directly to times, a point in our history where things are changing, that there's a kind of an evolutionary shift.
A leap of evolution. This is what the Mayas prophesied when referring to the date of 2012. And the appearance of Mayan figures and symbols in wheat fields would suggest that the mysterious architects of the crop circles want to draw our attention to current events and towards the end of this era. Actually, the use of the term prophecy regarding Mayan people is not quite correct. The Mayas, in fact, had identified regular cycles of time occurring in the universe. On the basis of this knowledge, they were able to predict centuries in advance astronomical events of great importance, which would affect the whole of mankind. To calculate these cycles, the Mayas had developed a complex system of calendars that they used in order to synchronize their existence with the flow of events and of cosmic energies. The shorter cycle that they calculated was 52 years long and was obtained through the interaction of two different calendars: the sacred calendar, called the Dzogchen, and the civil one, called Hab. The Dzogchen was formed by 13 months of 20 days each, for a total of 260 days, corresponding to the average length of gestation of a human being. The Hab calendar was made up of 18 months of 20 days each, for a total of 360 days. In order to obtain the solar year 365 days long, there was an addition of a 5-day month called Uaib. According to their studies, our solar system undergoes a circular motion toward and away from the center of the galaxy, the Milky Way, which lasts 25,625 years. The Mayas called this cycle Galactic Day and subdivided it into 5 subcycles of 5,125 years each, which they considered as individual eras and were called suns. At the end of each sun, they presumed that a strong energy flow would be generated from the center of the galaxy, causing a strong and unusual solar activity associated with global catastrophes. In fact, in 1997, the SOHO spacecraft detected an energy flow from the center of the galaxy, and a few years later, the Sun entered a very strong activity cycle. This gave scientific support to what had been anticipated by the Mayas.
The Maya civilization knew the behavior of the Sun and knew of its cycles. They knew that during this time, a macro cycle would have ended. I hope they were wrong. But according to what they're telling us, and to what's happening, we can expect a very serious situation with regard to the Sun in the coming years.
Also, the Mayan forecast regarding the energy coming from the center of the galaxy appeared in a crop circle on July 13, 1996, in West Kennet. The figure shows the Mayan symbol Hunab-Ku, which represents the galactic center. You can clearly see rays coming out of its perimeter. Next to Hunab-Ku, there are the crescent moon and a comet. How is this connection possible between the Mayan prophecies and the crop circles? Yet the messages coming from the pictograms are even more accurate. In fact, the astronomical depictions of the crop circles often indicate dates too, and in this case, the sky shown refers to a specific date. According to current knowledge, this layout of the sky should occur in December 2012. Does this perhaps indicate the peak of its energetic intensity? The Mayas remembered that already 4 suns, namely 4 cycles of 5,125 years each, had elapsed since the beginning of the Great Cycle or Galactic Day. Thus, according to their calculations, we are now at the end of the era of the 5th sun, which began on August the 13th, 3114 BC, and will end on December the 21st, 2012. During this period, the Mayas predicted new upheavals on our planet and a great spiritual renewal in humans. The survivors would have started a new golden age. A change that, according to some researchers, has already begun.
The other thing is that the law of karma is becoming more powerful. Bad people are being banged. Good people are being rewarded. It's happening more and more. What we think is what we get. And this becomes more and more direct as time goes on, because we are in the middle of this shift. Well, I think when the shift is complete in 2012, it'll be a completely new planet. I think it's going to hurt, but...
Among the most important Mayan documents where their prophecies are reported, there is certainly the Dresden Code. This is one of the three existing codes which survived the destructive fury of the conquistadors. Called after the German city where it's kept, the Dresden Code is the most informative one. It contains forecasts anticipating with astonishing accuracy some astronomical phenomena and events that will take place even in the distant future. In this code is held one of the most impressive astronomical predictions of the Maya. In fact, they predicted centuries in advance, with an error of just a few seconds, the eclipse of the 11th of August 1991, one of the most spectacular of the last century that took place in Mexico. This eclipse is associated with a figure that represents death, sitting on a throne of bones. It symbolizes the old age, the era that is ending. The prediction or prophecy says, "Woe to you people of the earth, the end of the Jaguar Nights will come, together with the beginning of a new era that will rise from the ashes of the previous one. It will be the time of the encounter with the Lords of the Stars." Therefore, the eclipse is considered by the Mayas as the starting point of the process bringing the end of the old era and the encounter with the Masters from the Stars. Could it mean the contact between humanity and an alien civilization coming from the cosmos? Will it be through this contact that mankind will live the new golden age anticipated by the Mayas?
On the 11th of August 1991, a disc-shaped unidentified object was sighted in the skies over Mexico City. It was the beginning of a long series of sightings by witnesses of an unprecedented wave of UFOs along the whole Mexican territory. Afterwards, incredible waves also occurred in other parts of the world. Like Belgium and ex-USSR countries, increasing the general attention on the UFO phenomenon like never before.
And what about the crop circles? Remarkably, since that year, the circles started appearing with greater frequency, and the figures became more complex and fascinating. It was as if both phenomena obey the same command, as if they were part of the same project. Almost using the same language of the Mayan prophecy contained in the Dresden Code, the Lords of the Circles put a signature on the English fields by using a symbol that belongs to the Sumerian civilization. It is called Dean Gear and appeared in 1992, incorporated into a pictogram representing the solar logos, which also means union of heaven and earth. The symbol Dean Gear means the just people traveling on celestial ships of fire. Who are the just people, and what about the celestial ships of fire? Is it a coincidence that the Dean Gear appears together with another symbol that indicates link, union between heaven and earth? The similarity with what was announced by the Mayas is extraordinary, but there is more. Why a Sumerian symbol and not a Mayan one? What is the connection between this symbol, the Dresden Code prophecy, and UFOs? The answer might come from the experience of an American policeman, Lonnie Zamora, on the 24th of April 1964, near the town of Socorro, New Mexico.
In 1964, New Mexico, the policeman Lonnie Zamora witnessed the landing of an object of unknown nature. He talked about it to his colleagues who arrived soon after the object had flown away. The ground was deeply embossed. That confirmed the landing of the object. On the side of the UFO, Zamora saw a particular symbol, a sort of arrow inside a semicircle. When his colleagues arrived, a few minutes after the happening, the ground was still hot and the policeman was visibly shaken.
On the side of the ovoid UFO was imprinted a symbol that Zamora would never forget, the Dean Gear. Incredibly, this symbol appeared again in the summer of 1999. inside a giant pictogram about 300 meters long. There were also, in greater numbers than the first time, the symbols of union between heaven and earth. But the connection between crop circles and what was announced by the prophecy of the Dresden Code regarding the masters from the stars is not just restricted to these occurrences. Clearer and far more important events started taking place in 2000. On the 13th of August 2000, near the Chilbolton Military Radio Telescope, appeared a beautiful crop circle that could not be deciphered. Its proximity to an installation supervised 24 hours a day makes it difficult, if not impossible, to think about a human origin. Its explanation arrived unexpectedly the year after. In fact, in the same field, on August the 14th, 2001, a new pictogram appeared. This time, however, it was not the usual symbol. This is, in fact, a face with clear humanoid features, designed with the same technique used for the old black and white photos of newspapers. A set of points where the difference of width and distance between them creates the image. A technique never seen before in crop circles. By applying a graphic filter on the photo, more details become clear.
If we apply a Gaussian filter 6.6 pixels wide, you see how light and shadow are outlined, proving that that being was alive when the picture was shot or when they impressed this image into the wheat field.
Just 5 days later, on August the 19th, a few dozen meters away from the alien face, an even more shocking figure appeared. It seemed the reply to the binary code message transmitted by the Arecibo radio telescope in 1974. It was right in that year, in fact, that Frank Drake, scientist and director of Arecibo at the time, together with the famous astronomer Carl Sagan, tried to communicate with a group of stars identified as M13. It sent out a message of introduction of mankind to a hypothetical alien civilization, indicating data on our numerical system, on the basic atoms of terrestrial life, on the structure of human DNA, and of our solar system with the Earth's relative position. They also included data relative to the Arecibo radio telescope. According to calculations, the message should have taken 25,000 years to reach its destination, and the same again to receive a reply. A really long time, let alone the fact that no one could tell whether that group of stars really hosted a supposed alien civilization. These circumstances make even more startling the appearance of the Chilbolton pictogram. Is it possible that someone received our message and replied to it much earlier than expected?
We have the same numerical system with zero and one. Therefore, the answers are universal. The basic atoms of life are the same, but in their body there is also silicon. Then, where the chemistry of DNA is mentioned, we also notice the fact that all the components of our DNA are clearly identical to theirs. This shows that we come from the same universal principle. When they mention their genome, they tell us that they have 1,048,000 sequences more than us. This means that they are much more evolved than us, which is normal. Since they have been able to achieve such a development, to prepare a similar message, they ought to have a greater evolution. Then they provide other details, telling us that they live in two planets and four moons, namely in six different worlds. And finally, they refer to the instrument used to send out this message. Surprisingly, we found that the figure representing this device appeared 1 year before in the same place. Thus, they notified that in the same place they would have given a new message. The way in which these beings speak to us needs to be carefully interpreted.
The elements involved in the Chilbolton pictograms are astonishing. Is this really the reply of an alien civilization? Is it fake or real? The Mayan Dresden Code announces that, starting from the 1991 eclipse, it has begun a process that will lead humanity to the encounter with the Lords of the Stars. Are these events part of it? 1 year after the Arecibo reply, exactly on the 15th of August 2002, in the fields of Crabwood Farm, west of Winchester, there appeared an even more amazing crop circle. It depicts an alien who holds a CD on which is carved a binary code message. This is the ASCII programming language for computers. Some researchers have decoded it.
This figure tells us several things. Very interesting indeed. It tells us, beware the bearers of false gifts and their broken promises.
Yo no sé si esto se dirige hacia lo que significa.
I don't know if this is related to what is, meaning global warming, or to wrong messages that they have given us, or if on the other hand, it is directly related to the beginning of the war in Iraq, given that this warning, this message, appeared in August 2002. Then, in the same message, it says, much pain, but still time. Again, we can attribute this to both issues, either what was happening on Earth or the Iraqi war. Then it goes on to say, believe there is good out there, which is the most important phrase, because it tells us that God exists, it tells us that the good, the upright exist, that they are our friends. I reckon it is an optimistic message for that reason. And finally it tells us, the conduit is closing. We don't know if this means that the communication would end there. I definitely hope not.
The so-called alien face from Crabwood Farm has raised much controversy about its authenticity. Yet, after many years, nobody has shown it to be a fake, and no one has claimed its creation. The complexity of its realization, simulating the structure of a television frame, the three-dimensional effect of the figure, the difficulty of achieving the binary code in a spiral, as in real compact discs, are all elements that make the hoax theory very unlikely. There is also another important element emerging from the encoding of the message. Some statements remind us of the Mayan prophecies. The phrase, there is good out there, confirms the very Mayan concept of a universe governed by firm laws of harmony. Much pain but still time seems to emphasize what was predicted by the prophecies on the years preceding the date of 2012. Finally, the conduit is closing seems a direct reference to the end of the cycle on the 21st of December 2012. Is it possible that the Mayas held knowledge coming from an alien civilization? The Chilbolton and Crabwood Farm circles seem to fit into the context of the Dresden Code prophecy on the contact with the Masters of the Stars. Also, since 2000, crop circles with Mayan symbols and with references to 2012 and to the end of the Mayan calendar have been appearing increasingly clear and in detail. On the 2nd of August 2004 was spotted one of the most beautiful Mayan-styled figures ever to appear. It represents the Mayan calendar of the long count, that is the cycle, or sun, in which we are now, that will end on the 21st of December 2012. It also indicates the eternal cycles of time and of the life-death wheel, the duality. This concept is expressed by the two wings at the center of the circle of the Chinese yin-yang symbol. The second figure appeared on the 9th of August 2005. It represents the sacred Mayan calendar, the Zolkin, a 260-day long calendar equivalent to the gestation period of a human being. The outside of the circle is composed of 20 elements, while in the inner circle there is a group of 13 bars, repeated four times. 13 times 20 is 260. This number corresponds to the days of the sacred Zolkin calendar, while 13 times 4 is 52, which is the number of years of a complete Zolkin-Hub cycle.
Los dos números son importantes.
Both numbers are important. Every 52 years, the 365-day solar calendar and the 260-day civil calendar joined up, starting from the same day, called the New Fire Ceremony. Looking toward the center of this figure, we have a half bow that indicates day zero. It is the day when the Pleiades, the Sun and the Earth line up. And this happens exactly every 20th of May. But in this case, the figure also represents a partial sun eclipse. On the 20th of May 2012, there will be a partial sun eclipse. Therefore, they are indicating a very precise date. They give us both the day and the year, May 20th, 2012.
Surprisingly, 60 days after the spring equinox of the 21st of March 2012, that is precisely May the 20th, 2012, at noon, the sun will be aligned with the Pleiades above the zenith of the pyramid of Chichen Itza. Are these just coincidences? Why do the creators of the circles want to point out this date? The pyramid of Chichen Itza was built in honor of the god Quetzalcoatl, or Kukulcan, of which the Mayas and all the South American peoples were waiting for the return. Is this a new reference to the return of the Masters of the Stars? But let's continue to analyze the circle. Opposite to the zero symbol, there are two groups of eight lances or feathers. 8 plus 8 is 16. Exactly 16 days after day zero, there will be a transit of Venus in front of the Sun, the last one during this century. It is a phenomenon that occurs only twice every 100 years or so and was considered very important by the Mayas, since it coincided with two cycles of 52 years of their Zolkin-Hub calendar. In this case, the transit is even more important because it is the last one for the three cycles of 25,625, 5,125 and 52 years, which all end in 2012. Let's go back to Earth. A few days later, exactly on the 13th of August 2005, another pictogram with clear Mayan symbols appeared in a nearby field. It consists of a circle in which a square is inscribed, that in turn contains another circle. This is the representation of the Mayan microcosm-macrocosm, the hermetic concept of, as on the top, so is it at the bottom. But according to some researchers, the square inside the circle would have an even deeper meaning.
We had a repetition of an ancient, a sacred geometry exercise known as squaring the circle. Now, this is very important because the square in time, well, forever, the square is the world, reality, mechanical, solid reality, a linear time symbolized by a square. And the circle is heaven and God and the divine. So the exercise is to make a square whose perimeter is exactly the same length as the circumference of the circle. And the crop circles have been saying, square the circle, square the circle, square the circle, square the circle.
Thus, squaring the circle means balancing the material and spiritual aspects of life. But let's go back to the pictogram and to the other extraordinary symbolism that it represents. In the middle, we have the Hunab Ku, that besides being a symbol of the Mayan divinity of creation, is also a six-pointed star, that is the monogram of Christ. This could mean an extraordinary identity. Is it possible that what for us stands for the essence of the divinity of creation was the same for the Mayas? Since 2005, which was marked by the two beautiful Mayan pictograms that we have seen, every year A crop circle with symbols clearly referring to this ancient civilization appears. The crop circle on the 15th of August 2006 is the Mayan symbol for Venus. We can therefore deduce that it refers to the end and to the beginning of the new cycle of transits of Venus in front of the Sun, a cycle that is for this century, as indicated in the pictogram on the 9th of August 2005, will end with the transit on June 2012. Therefore, we can say that this figure marks the transition from the old era, or 5th Sun, to the new era, or 6th Sun, that will begin on Saturday, December the 22nd, 2012. But Venus is also important for another fact. The Mayas were aware that at the end of its cycle of eclipses, the Sun would have manifested and would have spoken. With this, they meant a strong increase of activity of our star. Activity that would have deeply influenced our civilization and our planet.
In their oral tradition, the Mayas handed on indications of how the Sun would have behaved, the fact that all natural systems would have gone out of control. And that is exactly what is happening. Very few astronomers consider the importance of the Sun, but it's the Sun that is causing climate change, more than man himself.
On the 31st of July 2007, NASA found a spot on the Sun that was white instead of black. This indicates that its polarity was reversed compared to a normal spot. Scientists have revealed that this is an anomaly that indicates the beginning of cycle number 24 of solar maxima and of subsequent storms. The highest peaks with an activity of abnormal power are foreseen by the American space body for the years 2010, 2011 and 2012. Exactly when Venus will have completed its cycle of eclipses. The same period in which, as announced by the Mayas, the Sun will talk, that is to say, it will manifest its full power.
The last solar maximum occurred in 2001. The next one is expected between 2011 and 2012. During a normal solar maximum on the surface of our star, there are between 80 and 100 spots. Around 2011 and 2012, they are expected to be between 150 and 180 spots. I mean that there will be a cycle of cycles. This has a serious number of consequences, and global warming goes hand in hand with climate change. In practice, the seasons all over the world are out of phase, reaching every year record peaks of drought or excessive storms. Every year, there are more intense hurricanes, more powerful monsoons affecting even places where they had never occurred before. For instance, what about the hurricane that struck Brazil in 2005? And about the hurricane season in 2005 with Wilma and Katrina? A season in which the climate has become much harsher. There is evidence, many scientifically well-substantiated facts, right?
But the crop circle on the 15th of August 2006 is also the Mayan glyph called Lamat, name and symbol of the 8th day of the sacred Dzogchen calendar. And it is exactly a Lamat, the day in which begins and ends the period of the Mayan prophecy of the Dresden Code regarding the contact of humanity with the masters from the stars. Also in the Dresden Code, on the last page, the Mayas have depicted an image symbolizing how the end of humanity will happen. You see water flowing from the mouth of a snake, from the sun and from the moon. May it be interpreted as a devastating flood? Water, however, symbolizes also truth, spiritual knowledge, and the sign of the new era is the aquarium, whose symbol is in fact a man pouring water. As already mentioned in the Dresden Code, is prophesied the encounter with the masters of the stars. Thus, the water coming out of the snake, from the sun and the moon, and the water in the symbol of Aquarius, could have the same meaning. Water of knowledge. Truth poured on Earth by evolved people coming from the sky. Truth that overwhelms the false concepts with which humanity has been living until now, and that are seriously leading us toward the risk of self-destruction. In the light of these considerations, the crop circles could be seen as a genuine attempt to communicate.
I think this is the first communication. It's not a message. It's a very clever curriculum, very clever agenda. Because we have become corrupted and degenerate, and they're returning us to spirit.
In 2007, a new crop circle with Mayan symbols appeared on August the 12th. It was the Mayan number 6, made by a bar and a dot. The dot is the unit, the bar is number 5. A very simple circle that left researchers somewhat disappointed. But following extensive research and analysis of its meaning, irrefutable correlations between the number 6 and the Mayan prophecies were brought to light. The simple pictogram became as important as the Mayan circles from previous years. A few weeks earlier, a circle with Aztec features appeared, indicating August the 18th, 2007, through astronomical symbols. On that date, there would have been a conjunction between the Sun and Venus. The circle with the Mayan 6 appeared on August the 12th. Thus, there were exactly 6 days left to get to the same conjunction indicated a few days before by the Aztec formation. In addition, before the next transit of Venus in front of the Sun on the 6th of June 2012, another 6 conjunctions like this one will occur. An astronomical event, announced also by the previous circles, whose meaning we have already analyzed. Moreover, if we count from the year of its appearance, we find out that the circle of the Mayan 6 shows also the number of years left to 2012.
Such a 6 is often taken as the symbol for heaven, so we have a heavenly design surrounded by the unity of the One, the Oneness. In such a simple design, such a powerful, powerful, powerful message.
In short, a figure far from being simple or random, not only for its meaning. If we look more closely at the pictogram, the concept of paradise described by Gary King emerges also in relation to the Mayas. Within the small circle representing the unity, the layout of wheat forms 13 spirals perfectly highlighted. An important Mayan prophecy is called of 9 hells and 13 heavens. With the 9 hells, the Mayas indicated the period beginning in 1519, the year in which the Spanish conquistadors landed on their shores, and ending in December 2012. From that moment, the 13 heavens will begin. So, the message of the circle might also be the following. 6 more years are to go before the beginning of the period of the 13 heavens. The message that comprises, in fact, was explained by Gary King. We could still carry on describing further data and symbols related to the knowledge and prophecies of the Mayas, which have appeared in the extraordinary English crop circles. Could the Mayas really predict future events? Do these warnings have a real foundation? Now, even scientists confirm that the Earth is a living entity, a complex organism. The message coming from the ancient Mayas and modern crop circles appears to be the same. A change of conscience is absolutely necessary, as never before in human history. A message of warning and hope coming from a past whose importance is hardly being recognized.
It is funny that now it's happening, exactly what has been announced. Changes are predicted and it seems that they are actually taking place. Thus, looking at our old generations or ancient civilizations as if they were less developed and therefore inferior to us is wrong. They were as intelligent as we are, or even smarter. After the tsunami in 2005, NASA checked on March 21st, 2005 and recorded with absolute precision the spring equinox from Chichen Itza. Why? Because they did not possess a single tool that allowed them to determine the position of the sun with the same accuracy with which it is measured at Chichen Itza. So we see that not only modern science accepts the phenomenon, but it even needs it. This means that not only does it accept the fact that these ancient civilizations had a very precise knowledge, but they are even taking advantage of it. Therefore, considering this, I suggest that we should begin to respect the ancient civilizations.
And this is what the creators of the pictograms did. Whether human or alien, they amplified the message coming from the cultures of the past, such as the Mayas, through a fascinating symbolism beautifully engraved on the wheat fields of England.
It is funny that now it's happening, exactly what has been announced. Changes are predicted and it seems that they are actually taking place.
This is the best footage and most comprehensive footage available of when the crop circle takes.
I think this is the first communication.
This points directly to times, a point in our history where things are changing.